Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and thank you for joining me for the second video in our remainder theorem series, in which we will look at divisors of the form ax plus or minus b. If this is the first time that you're learning about the remainder theorem, then be sure to check out the first video in the series, which covers divisors of the form x plus or minus b. In the last video, we learned that a polynomial can be written as a divisor multiplied by a quotient plus a remainder, where we focused specifically on divisors of the form x minus a. And according to the remainder theorem, it stated that when a polynomial function f of x is divided by x minus a, then the remainder is equal to f of a. This worked because substituting a in place of x left us with a divisor of 0. Of course, 0 multiplied by a quotient plus the remainder just left us with 0 plus the remainder, which just left us with the remainder. The same logic is used with divisors of the form ax minus b, but the remainder theorem needs a slight adjustment. It states that when a polynomial f of x is divided by a divisor ax minus b, then the remainder is equal to f of b over a. Well, let's explore why that's true. If we replace the x in the divisor with b over a, we notice that the a's cancel, and that just leaves us with b minus b, which of course is equal to 0. Again, this leaves us with the situation of 0 multiplied by the quotient plus the remainder, which gives us 0 plus the remainder, and ultimately, the remainder. Okay, let me make this really, really, really easy for us to understand. If we want the remainder, all we have to do is substitute the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0. For example, if the divisor is 5x minus 8, we make it equal to 0 and solve for x, which gives us positive 8 over 5. Or perhaps the divisor is 2x plus 1. All we need to do is make it equal to 0 and again solve for x, which gives us negative 1 over 2. Let's consider this example, which asks, what is the remainder when 4x cubed plus 10x squared minus 30x plus 16 is divided by 2x minus 3? We could start by creating a polynomial function from this expression by letting f of x equal to that 4x cubed plus 10x squared minus 30x plus 16. As we can see, the divisor is of the form ax minus b, which means that we need to use the adjusted version of the remainder theorem and substitute b over a in place of x. In this case, 3 over 2. In other words, we substitute the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0. And when we do that, we are left with the case of 0 multiplied by the quotient plus the remainder, which just gives us 0 plus the remainder, and ultimately just that remainder. Here is what we actually need to do in our calculations. We take that original polynomial function, and wherever we see x's, we replace them with 3 over 2's. And then simplify. And just be careful, because simplifying these fractions can get a little tricky. So, according to the remainder theorem, the remainder is 7. And if you'd like, you can check your work by using long division as well as synthetic division. And both of them confirm that the remainder is 7. And that's the remainder theorem in a nutshell. In conclusion, if we are looking for the remainder of a polynomial division, we simply find the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0, and we substitute that value into the dividend in order for us to get the remainder in seconds. Want a challenge? Well, try out this question and let me know what your answer is in the comments below so I can see how smart you are. If you found this video helpful, then please let me know. And if you'd like to consider the idea of supporting me and my work on Patreon, then please click on the link in the description to learn more. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.